Hi friends, today I'm going to share some knowledge about one of the most important topic, that is hernia, which is very important as theoretical point of view, practical, and even for PG preparation exam. I'll be dealing with it under these headings: introduction, etiology, parts of hernia, classification, surgical anatomy of inguinal hernia, femoral hernia also, because these two are most common, clinical features, which include signs and symptoms, and management, which includes investigations and treatment. Introduction. What is hernia? Hernia is defined as an abnormal protrusion of a viscous or a part of a viscous through an opening that can be an artificial one or a natural one with a sac covering it. However, there are many hernias without any sac. Hernia in Greek means offshoot, or in Latin means rupture. 75 to 85% of abdominal wall hernias are all groin hernias, and 15% of male and 5% of female are all groin hernias. Most common hernia, that is 73% of occurrence, is inguinal hernia, and in inguinal hernia, indirect hernia is most common than direct hernia. And in female, femoral hernia is the most common hernia. This can be asked as an MCQ for PG entrance exams. Etiology. Etiology for hernia, it can be straining, lifting of heavy weight, chronic cough, conditions like tuberculosis, asthma, emphysema, chronic constipation, obesity, urinary causes like benign prostatic hypertrophy, CA prostrate, ascites, appendicectomy. You may wonder how appendicectomy is related to hernia. Appendicectomy, an operation which deals with the removal of appendix, during the operation, if the ilioinguinal nerve is damaged, leads to the weakening of the wall, which may lead to hernia. Parts of hernia, this is the neck, narrowest part, body, and fundus. Classification. Hernia broadly is classified under four headings. One, clinical. Reducible hernia, irreducible hernia, obstructed hernia, inflammable hernia, strangulated hernia. And second, it may be congenital or acquired. According to the contents, it is mainly omentocele, which contains omentum, enterocele, intestine, cystocele, urinary bladder. These are some hernias with fancy names which can be asked as an MCQ. Litter's hernia, which includes Meckel's diverticulum as a content. Meidel's hernia, where the intestinal loop is in the W shape. You can remember it as M when made in opposite direction appears like W. Sliding hernia, where posterior wall is also the content, like intestine or a bladder, very most common in left side with sigmoid colon in the posterior wall. Richter's hernia, part of the loop is included as a content. Amiad's hernia, appendix is a content. Gibbon's hernia, inguinal hernia plus hydrocele. Pantaloon hernia, which includes direct and indirect hernia. And sportsman hernia. Sportsman hernia is so called because it was present in one of the sportsmen, who was Sachin Tendulkar, where hernia was, there was hernia through a tear in the posterior muscle wall. Based on the sites, it's inguinal, femoral, obturator, diaphragmatic, lumbar, spigelion, umbilical, epigastric. Surgical anatomy of inguinal canal. This is the anterior superior iliac spine and pubic tubercle. These are the two bony landmarks. Extending from anterior superior iliac spine to pubic tubercle is the inguinal ligament. This is a conjoint tendon. This is a rectus muscle. This is superficial inguinal ring. This is a deep inguinal ring. This vessel is the inferior epigastric artery. This is the inguinal canal. And about the surgical anatomy of femoral canal, this occurs in the anterior compartment of the thigh. This is a femoral sheath, which is including femoral artery, femoral vein, femoral branch of genital femoral nerve. This is the femoral canal, which is the medial most compartment. It is having lymph node in it. Clinical features includes symptoms and signs. Symptoms, mainly patient comes with swelling with or without pain. Pain, if present, is a dragging type of pain. And signs, deep ring occlusion test is the most significant sign. Ring invagination test, Zeeman test. Deep ring occlusion test, you're gonna occlude the deep ring using your thumb and ask the patient to cuff after reducing the contents. If you feel the impulse on thumb, it means it is indirect hernia. Ring invagination hernia, a simple test using your little finger, where you take a fold of skin through the scrotum and push the contents to the superficial inguinal ring. And if you feel the impulse after the person is asked to cuff on your palp, it means it is direct hernia. And if you feel the impulse on tip, it means it is indirect hernia. Zeeman's test using your three fingers, index, middle and ring finger. Index finger is used to occlude deep ring. Middle finger is used to occlude superficial ring. And ring finger is used to occlude saphenous opening. Other two tests to check the abdominal wall tone, that is head rising and leg rising or Valsalva manure. To check the tone of the abdominal wall muscle and Malgagni bulgings. After examination of hernia, we should never forget to examine the opposite side of the person, per-rectal examination, urethral examination and abdominal muscle tone. Important differences between indirect and direct inguinal hernia. Indirect hernia can occur in any age, whereas direct occurs most commonly in elderly. It needs a pre-existing sac inguinal canal. It is always acquired. It is through the deep ring. It is through the posterior wall of inguinal canal, that is the Hazelback triangle, which is bounded by inguinal ligament, outer border of rectus, inferior epigastric vessels. It is piriform or oval in shape. It is globular or round in shape. It is piriform or oval in shape because it has to travel through the tract, then come out. Can be complete. It is very rare. Anterolateral to the cord, posterior to the cord. And entrocele and omentocele. You need to know clinically how do you differentiate entrocele and omentocele. Entrocele is very difficult to reduce for the first part, and for the last part it is easy. Why is it so? Because while reducing the first part, the gas and the contents go and obstruct the deep ring. So it is difficult for the first part. But once the contents are gone, second part is very easy. Omentocele, first part is easy, second part is difficult. Bowel sounds are heard in enterocele. Omentocele, it is not heard. Peristalsis can be seen in enterocele as it is an intestine. In omentocele, it is not seen. Easy way to remember enterocele, E. E for easy, E for enterocele is the last part. And management, which includes investigations. It is diagnosis of hernia as such is a clinically diagnosed, but you may also use ultrasound or MRI. Treatment can be open or laparoscopic. In open herniatomy, which is not practiced now. In herniatomy, this is the defect. And this is the sac. This is the content. In second step, we have opened the sac, pushed the content downward and left it open. Defect is left open. This is herniatomy. Hernia roughy included all these steps 1, 2, 3 plus the two edges of the defect are sutured together. Hernioplasty is mesh. Most commonly we use proline to cover and strengthen these defect. Lichenstein, tension-free mesh hernioplasty is the surgery choice. And laparoscopically, it is TEP or TAP. TEP is total extra peritoneal repair. TAP is transabdominal preperitoneal repair. TEP is better than TAP always. Friends, do concentrate on the topic hernia. It is very important for your entrance exam point of view. Even for your theory, it is a 10 marker for the UG and practical point of view. Thank you.